الحمد لله الحمد لله وحده والصلاة والسلام على من لا نبي بعده على من لا نبي بعده ولا أمة بعد أمته ولا كتاب بعد كتابه ولا شريعة بعد شريعته. أما بعد، فأعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم، بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. لا يكلف الله نفسا إلا وسعها، لها ما كسبت وعليها ما اكتسبت. صدق الله العظيم. Respected viewers, welcome to our program Reflections, where we reflect upon the message of Almighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I have recited the last verse, or at least a portion of the last verse of Surah Baqarah. And these are part of very significant verses. Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam one day told the Sahaba that Jibreel alayhi salatu wa sallam came down from the heaven, and he came and told me that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has sent down two lights, the like of which has not been revealed in the Torah and the Zabur and in other portions of the Holy Quran. These two lights are Surah Fatiha and the last two verses of Surah Baqarah. We have done certain portions of Surah Fatiha in one of our earlier programs. Here we do the last two verses of Surah Baqarah, part of the two lights. And what is the background? In the verse just preceding the last two verses, Allah Ta'ala says, وَإِن تُبْدُوا مَا فِي أَنفُسِكُمْ أَوْ تُخْفُوهُ يُحَاسِبْكُمْ بِهِ اللَّهِ. If you conceal something or you reveal it, Allah will take into account what you are doing. So this was very difficult for the companions. The reason why they found it very difficult, Sahaba were not like you and I. They wanted everything to be perfect. So they said, Ya Rasulullah, we can understand Allah Ta'ala taking account with regard to the apparent deeds of ours. But Allah Ta'ala taking account even with regard to our thoughts? And thoughts are plenty. Thoughts are plenty. And sometimes thoughts are not always pure. We find different types of thoughts. The different types of thoughts that come upon us. Is Allah Ta'ala going to take account from us for even those things? Now Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam knew that this was not the case. And it was later to be clarified. But Allah Ta'ala wanted to give a lesson to the Sahaba and to all of us. Oh my Sahaba, when Allah Ta'ala reveals something, then even if it's difficult, your initial reaction should be one of submission. Thereafter, you can clarify the matter. Rather, always say, oh Allah, we are weak, but we would like to submit, Ya Allah. Help us in this submission. آمن الرسول بما أنزل إليه من ربه والمؤمنون. The prophets of Almighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the mu'minun, they believe in Allah. Kullun amana billahi wa malaikati. We believe in Allah, the malaika, the kutub and the rusuli. La nufarriqu bayna ahadin min rusuli. We make no distinction with regard to our belief in the Anbiya alayhi salatu wa salam. We know that there is differences in status amongst the Anbiya alayhi salatu wa salam. But in terms of the message, we make no difference. My ustad used to tell me, and he used to tell us in our class, also part of it, we don't make a distinction in a way that belittles or regards any of the Anbiya alayhi salatu wa salam as insignificant. La nufarriqu bayna. We believe in all the Anbiya alayhi salatu wa salam and the message that came to them from Almighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Sami'na, qalu, and say, sami'na, we have heard of Allah, and we will strive to obey, and we will strive to be obedient. Wufranak, and oh Allah, forgive us. Forgive us for our shortcomings. Wa ilayka al-masir, and to you is our return. Submission, in reality, is the essence of faith. وَمَنْ أَحْسَنُ دِينًا مِمَّنْ أَسْلَمَ وَجَهُ. Says Allah in the fifth juz of the Holy Quran, whose deen is better than the one who submits to the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So Allah ta'ala tells us to submit. So when this verse was revealed that Allah will take into account, apparently it seemed Allah will take into account even your thoughts. Sahaba found it difficult. Allah Ta'ala told them that whenever you find any command, always reflect, but always show submission, show obedience, show that you want to do it. Respected viewers, many a times we find certain commands of Allah, or we hear about something, we might find it difficult. But the initial reaction of the believer, and the reaction of the believer, سَمِعْنَا وَعَطَعْنَا. Oh Allah, we have heard, we will strive to obey. Do not be among those who say, سَمِعْنَا وَعَسَيْنَا. Oh Allah, we have heard and we will rebel and we will disobey. We are not amongst them. We are people who submit to the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then the next verse goes on to say, لَا يُكَلِّفُ اللَّهُ نَفْسًا إِلَّا وُسْعَهَا. all my sahaba, all my companions, all the ummah of Nabi Karim sallallahu alaihi wasallam, Allah will never put upon you a burden that is beyond you to carry out. Allah will never put a burden. Allah will never give you a command that you will find it impossible to carry out. I narrated perhaps previously, and let me make mention of it now. One day a person came to a scholar and said, I cannot get up for Fajr prayers. I cannot get up for the early morning prayers. The scholar told him, I take an oath that you are lying. I take an oath that you are lying. So he said, what do you mean? He said, if you could not get up for the early morning prayers, Allah would never have made it compulsory. Because Allah says, La yukallifu Allahu nafsan illa wusaha. I never impose or put any command upon a believer that it is impossible and it is burdensome and he cannot carry out. Oh my sahaba, even this aspect with regard to your thoughts, if it comes involuntarily, if you bring your thoughts and you start thinking of guna and sin, it is wrong. It is wrong. But if something comes to you involuntarily, you did not bring it and all of a sudden a thought comes which is not very pure, then there is no sin with regard to it. لَهَا مَا كَسَبَتْ وَعَلَيْهَا مَكْتَسَبَتْ. For a human being is the reward of the good that he has done. And there is the liability and the accountability and the punishment for the wrong that he has done. لَهَا مَا كَسَبَتْ وَعَلَيْهَا مَكْتَسَبَتْ. So in reality, this verse teaches us the greatest aspect of submission. Then it concludes with a beautiful dua. رَبَّنَا لَا تُؤَاخِذْنَا إِن نَسِينَا وَأَخْطَعْنَا. O Allah, do not catch us. Do not seize us with regard to those things that we have heard or we have forgotten. رَبَّنَا لَا تَحْمِلْ عَلَيْنَا إِسْرًا كَمَا حَمَلْتَهُ عَلَى الَّذِينَ مِنْ قَبْلِنَا. O Allah, do not impose and put upon us a burden and difficulty the way that was done upon the people of the past. رَبَّنَا لَا تُحَمِّلْنَا مَا لَا تَاقَةَ لَنَا بِهِ. O Allah, do not impose upon us challenges and difficulties that we cannot make and we cannot bear, Ya Allah. I always tell people to make this dua. O Allah, never bring difficulty upon us. Never let us see the difficulty of our children and our near and dear ones. Do not bring upon us difficulty that we cannot bear. We are weak, Ya Allah. They were the strong people that you tested and they came through the test with flying colors. We are weak, Ya Allah. Do not test us because we are weak. Do not put upon us any type of challenges that is beyond us to carry out. رَبَّنَا وَلَا تُحَمِّلْنَا وَعْفُ عَنَّا وَغْفِرْ لَنَا. Forgive us, Ya Allah, and have mercy upon us. وَارْحَمْنَا أَنْتَ مَوْلَانَا. You are our guide and our protector. فَانْصُرْنَا عَلَى الْقَوْمِ الْكَافِرِينَ. Help us against the evil people. Subhanallah. This is the beautiful two verses, the last two verses of Surah Baqarah. It was revealed upon our beloved Nabi Karim sallallahu alaihi wasallam at the time of Mi'raj. Amongst the gifts of Mi'raj, Nabi Karim sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, whoever reads these last two verses of Surah Baqarah in the evening, Allah will suffice for him. It is made mention on the authority of Umar radiallahu anhu, who said, only a fool misses out to recite these two verses before retiring to bed. It has a great lesson of submission, and that is part of today's reflection. وَآخِرُ دَعْوَانَا عَلِ الْحَمْدُ لِلَّهِ رَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ.